Hello, lovelies. Welcome to the last part of the Valentine's Day love series. And today I'm talking about collaboration and how to strengthen your partnership with your partner. So a couple of things. Before I jump into the content, let me share that we have an amazing event for a Valentine's Day experience coming this Sunday. It's going to be an amazing concept for creating more connection, deepening your love and feeling more in alignment with your partner. And the first part is going to be about learning interconnectedness and connection and consciousness and how to be in relationship with your partner in a better way. Number two is going to be an exercise for how to deepen your connection, how to have more connectedness, more fun, more alignment, just more togetherness without necessarily spending so much more time together. Some people might have a reaction to that. And then the third part is going to be about creating a piece of art to capture the essence of your connection as a souvenir for the event to take with you. So that's happening this Sunday. Feel free to register for that. The link is going to be in the caption and it's also in the link in bio. And feel free to join us. I would love to see you there. Now, for today's content, ready? Couple of things. So before I jump more specifically into collaboration and how to create that strong partnership with your partner, I want to show you how not having a few things ahead of time in place doesn't help you and create collaboration. It sets you back from creating collaboration. So the first thing is, if you have the wrong mindset about relationship, love, your partner, if you look at them funny, if you assign blame, if you assign motives, if you're always being critical, if you're being too demanding, if you have weird expectations, if you don't share your expectations, if you have limiting beliefs, whatever, all the things that have to do with your mindset, if they're a little off, it's gonna impact how you show up to interactions, into your collaboration, and creating the best life with your partner. So that's one thing that might get in the way. The second thing that gets in the way is if your communication is weird, right? So if you complain and whine and fight and escalate and use trigger words and they're not respectful and they're not mindful and you talk about your partner instead of talking about you, all kinds of different things that you do weird in your communication, that's also going to get in the way. Communication skills have not only to do with your words and how do you message what you're trying to share and let your partner know, but also your posture, your body language, just how you show up, your attunement, your presence. So it's verbal and nonverbal skills, tools in terms of how to phrase your messages. And thirdly, if you do put your foot in your mouth, how do you repair, how do you fix things so that you could get in more alignment and more easily communicate with your partner, resolve conflict, get on the same page, make good decisions, and so on. The third thing that might get in the way from creating a strong partnership is if you don't address your triggers in your sensitivities. So if you're walking around as a big old chicken bomb and your partner sneezes and you blow up, then that could create some difficulties in creating a strong partnership and good collaboration. So with that piece, what needs to happen is for you to get more in touch with what are your sensitivities, what are your wounds, what are the things that are driving you, what are your programs, what are your defenses, what are the things that show up in your relationship that you might not necessarily be aware of, but they're patterns, right? Things that continue to show up and replicate and always get you stuck. Those are driven by something that needs to be addressed. If that's not addressed, that's going to get in the way. How can you possibly create something beautiful with your partner if that stuff is still in the way? Now, your stuff is in the way, their stuff is in the way, your defenses of having a relationship, never mind feeling connection and feeling intimate and having the essence of you, the beautifulness of you, create a relationship. Now, so that was three. Four is connection, right? So what I find a lot, and I know this firsthand too, is that if I'm feeling disconnected with my partner, all the little things put me over the edge, right? That's when we have disagreements or arguments, or I'm not just talking about myself, but just couples. That's when we might get on our nerves more. That's when we might feel out of alignment and out of sync, and we don't like our partner so much. We feel unsupported. That has to do because our tank is empty. So any little friction is going to really grind, right? So our job is to put more in the emotional bank, more into our connection So there's more cushion there. So when the little things happen, they don't kick you in the butt, okay? So connection is very important for so many different reasons. It has to do with health, longevity, vitality, connectedness, happiness, all kinds of things. So investing in your connection is huge. That's why we're having our event on Sunday, and that's why all the work that we do with the couples, to help you strengthen that connection. Now, so if you address those four things, and they don't necessarily need to be in order, and they don't need to be, you know, you finish one and then the next one and then the next one. It doesn't have to be so concrete or discreet in the work that you, in the way that you do the work, but rather if you address them and you could tackle them all at the same time, a little bit here, a little bit there, as long as you're aware and intentional about these things, then you're in good shape to start working on your collaboration. What a lot of partners do is they want to address their collaboration and create their amazing life together, but all these things are not addressed yet, and that's why they don't do so well, you see? So if you're playing with those four elements first, then it's easier to collaborate, it's easier to get on the same page, and it's easier to create the life that you want together. Sorry if you hear tippy-tapping, my dog is pacing around. Okay, so now, assuming that you're playing with those four elements, that you're giving that some love and some attention, and you're massaging those things, you're learning your skills, you're learning your tools, and you're implementing that stuff, then the way that you address collaboration and creating the life that you want together is, number one, to have a vision of your life. What is it that you want to create? What are you trying to have at the end of the day? So it's the last day of your life, and looking back, it's like, did I create what I wanted? Did I have the life experience that I wanted to have? Did I make the most of my life? Am I leaving a legacy? What kind of life do I want to have lived, right? So all kinds of things like that. You got to think about that for yourself. Your partner could do the same thinking. Then you share that and you combine them to create something that makes sense for the both of you, and that's your joint life vision. Now, I said that very quickly and very high level. There's a lot that goes into that because sometimes our partner doesn't want to think about that, right? Or they don't want to talk about it. Or they want to do what they want to do and they don't care about it. What do you think? Or how do you want to do things? It gets tricky. That's why all the other elements need to be in place first. So when you get to this, you're already a well-oiled machine and it's much easier to have these conversations. Now, for those of you who have a partner who's not really involved actively in creating these things, like they're not like the geeky person who's like doing the workbook and watching the videos and investing in the relationship in a more studious way, that's totally fine. They're not a bad partner and they don't suck. They just have a different way. To each their own. That means that you are the partner that needs to lead this. It falls on you, and that's perfectly okay to be the leader of this thing. You could spearhead this, okay? That means that you develop the vision, knowing what you know about your partner and their preferences, things that they have shared. You grab your things, you combine them, you massage them, you create something, and you share it with your partner lightly without being like, by the way, this is our life vision that we're working on creating. Right? You're going to take it easy because that's going to be overwhelming to them otherwise. You're going to share this life vision. You're going to say, like, you know, I was thinking, is this something that makes sense for you? Like, do you think that this is what we're working on? This is the kind of life that we want to have? And organically, you address the life vision and you kind of get a buy-in. Whatever their feedback and response is, you integrate it into the big map, life map or idea that you have, the vision. And then you guys start working towards creating that, okay? What does that mean? You break it down into goals. 10-year goals, 5-year goals, 1-year goals, like what are we working on this year? And again, it doesn't have to be super, super formal. You don't want to freak out your partner if they're not that involved in doing things like this. You could do it for yourself if you like to geek out on this stuff. But just at least some kind of an idea. We're going to buy our new house this year. We're going to have this kind of vacation in the next 5 years, our most epic vacation ever. We're going to send our kids off to college, you know, whatever the thing is. Right, so you kind of have an idea of what you're working on. You agree on like, okay, this is the thing that we're working on, or these are the things that we want to achieve within this time frame. You see, so it doesn't have to be super rigid and super structured. So those are the goals. And then you talk about how you're going to go about creating those goals, which is, okay, what are you going to do? What am I going to do? So you divide and conquer, because you have different skills, different strengths, different preferences, different ways of doing things that might work better coming from one partner than coming from the other. Sometimes we leave things for a partner to do, but that's not their strength, right? And so either they totally don't get it, they mess it up, they avoid it. Same for us on our side. So what's the point? So divide and conquer according to your strengths and your preferences. And then decide, okay, so by when would you want to have that done? And seamlessly, without being a boss and super robotic about it, when do we want to work this thing by, right? What are the things that you're contributing? What are the things that I'm contributing? And you get on the same page about the actions, the behaviors, the habits, the tactics, the things that you're putting in place to achieve those goals, you see? And then the last piece about this is to create systems. Something that happens a lot in the sessions that when we have sessions with couples is that they share the same conflict over and over. So it's not like the way that they have the fight, which is part of the couples therapy work, but rather the same incident, right? So every time we have to leave the house to go here, this thing happens. Like, it hasn't been resolved yet. So what I want to offer is, if you have a thing that keeps happening over and over, resolve it once and for good. So say to yourselves, okay, so when this thing comes up, or in the future, when we go about doing this thing, this is how we should do it. What do you think? How do you think we should go about it so we don't get tripped up like we usually do? You see? And you brainstorm and you put things in place so that you address the thing so it doesn't come up again. Now, if you implement whatever you agreed to and there's still something wonky, that's okay. You just polish it, you finesse it, and then you tweak it, whatever, until you crack the code and this thing is no longer an issue. Okay? And I don't think I said the last thing that I was going to say. That was a side note. The last thing I want to say is to create systems, right? So if one of you is in charge of the finances, okay, how do we do finances? If one of you is in charge of the childcare, okay, what does that mean? If one of you is in charge of food shopping, okay, what does that mean? Right, so how do we create the shopping list? What time do we leave the house? What kind of spreadsheet do we use, you see? So you create a little system so that this is how we do things. You're not reinventing the wheel. You're not making life more complicated. The other person can pick off where you leave off if necessary, or back you up if you're not available or something happened, whatever. So there's a way that things get done. And again, it doesn't have to be super robotic or too structured, but there's a way that we do things so it's smooth and it's a well-oiled machine and everything gets done easily and effortlessly, and you could have more joy and free time to do other more funner things. Okay, so if you have any questions, feel free to put them here. Hang out here for one more minute. Feel free to give me some love, some thumbs, some hearts. Thank you so much. And also, if you're watching this in the recording, feel free to put comments or questions in the comments. And if you feel that you need support with all of this, check out our website, metrorelationship.com, for our services and what we offer so that we could support you. Remember, we have a fun event happening this Sunday. Check out the caption for the link for that. And we have all kinds of resources on our website, free things too, so that you could check it out and have the support and the help that you need to create the best relationship that you want to have, and enjoy your life with your partner. And lastly, if you missed the other recordings that I did this week, this was part 5, the other 4, I did one every day this week for Valentine's Day. Check it out. I have the whole series on YouTube, in the Linktree, and in some other places, or just wherever you're watching this. Feel free to look that up and enjoy all the videos. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you had a great Valentine's Day. Enjoy this holiday weekend coming up. I will see you guys on Sunday. Have a fantastic. I'll see you at the next one. Bye.